So good morning, everyone. In the previous class, we were discussing about different configuration of load, and we considered various possible combinations if we have the NMOS transistor in place of load. Okay, so we checked what happens if we have connected the gate terminal of NMOS transistor to grounded or to VDD. Or to the output node, or to somewhat higher voltage or lower voltage or something like that. And we tried to check how these circuits will behave and how they will work. Okay, so this was the thing which we have already discussed. So let us extend the analysis further and let us try to check what happens if I used to replace this load by the PMOS transistor. So in this particular slide, we considered like if we have the NMOS transistor which is acting as a load, then how it will behave, and we check the performances. Now let us see how this will behave if we can have a different combinations. So the first combination could be like, yes, so here we have the first combination, like, yeah, so if you can go back to the previous slide, in the previous slide we consider all the load transistors was made of the NMOS transistors. Okay, now let us try to check few more combinations so that you will get some idea how the circuit behaves and how we can optimize the different parameters. Okay, so here the first combination, like here we have a PMOS load is connected, and if the first example, yeah, first combination could be like, let us try to connect this gate to the grounded. Okay, so suppose I have connected this gate terminal of this PMOS transistor or the load transistor to the grounded, in that case how this circuit will behave. Okay, so can anyone tell me how this circuit will be, whether it will act as an inverter or not? Anyone? If we see here.
Sir, if the Vin is zero, then we can have direct VDD, but if Vin is one, then it will be that voltage divider circuit.
Okay, so it will act as a voltage divider circuit, which we have already studied. Yes, so it means, suppose I have Vin is equal to zero, in this case this transistor will be in off state. Okay, so this VDD, because this PMOS transistor is always on. Okay, so this is always in on state because I have connected the gate terminal of this PMOS transistor to the grounded. So this is always on, so this VDD will be transferred to the V out. Okay, and if Vin is equal to zero, then this will perfectly pass the logic, which will be just like a VDD. Okay, so it will give some logic high. But if Vin is equal to one, in that case what will happen, both the transistors will be on, then this circuit will behave as a voltage divided circuit. And of course, what is the sizing of this transistor? That decides what is the minimum voltage. So this minimum voltage can be either this or it can be like this. That completely depends on what is the minimum value. This depends on what is the on resistance ratio of this pull-up network and the pull-down networks. So if the on resistance ratio is very high, what it means, the pull-up network is more stronger, and if it is more stronger, then this waveform will shift in this particular direction.
Hello, okay, excuse me, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, ye Vin high hone se ek baar fir batayega.
Okay, so what will happen? Let me draw this equivalent circuit here. So Vin is equal to zero is perfectly fine, right? So let me consider Vin is equal to one. If Vin is equal to one, in this case, this transistor is on, and this, because the PMOS transistor is always in on state. Okay, so if the PMOS transistor is always in on state, then what will happen, ma'am? The equivalent circuit will look like this.
Yes, sir, yes, sir.
This is how the equivalent circuit will look like. So we are taking output from here, and this is the R on of the PMOS transistor, and this is R on of NMOS transistor. Okay, Now, if the both the transistors have equal sizing, if both the transistors are equal sizing, then we know that the mobility of holes and electrons are different. Then the resistance will be different. This resistance will be different. Okay. So let us assume if both the size of both the transistors are equal, in that case, this particular resistance will be double than this one. Okay. And if this is double than this one, means one third the voltage out means I need to calculate the V out. This V out is nothing but this will be R on NMOS divided by R on NMOS plus R on PMOS into V in whatever we have, and that will be the V output. Okay, so if
VDD, right?
This is the VDD, yeah. Into VDD. So this will be the output voltage which we will receive. So what happens if R on, so if I am keep on increasing the strength of PMOS transistor, in that case, this will increase. So if this is going to increase, what it means, the denominator is increasing, means the V out will start reducing. So this is what, like, we can calculate what is the output voltage and how it works. Okay. So the shifting means where it will shift, that completely depends what is the resistance value and what is the transistor sizing value. So this is how it will work. So this is the first possible combinations. Yeah, definitely this will act as an inverter, but the lower logic, that completely depends on what is the transistor sizing. So transistor sizing play a major role. What is the value of VOL? So VOL is decided by the transistor sizing. Okay, VOL is nothing but this is the VOL. Okay, so VOL is the function of W by L. Okay, W by L of both the transistors. Okay, now let us go for the next circuit. Here we have the next possible combination. Suppose I have this kind of circuit, and I have what I am doing. I am just connecting this gate terminal of this PMOS transistor to the VDD. So can anyone comment whether this circuit will act as an inverter or not? Anyone?
Sir, upper wala to hamesha off reh jayega fir.
Okay, so if the upper one is always in off state, what it means, this will not act as an inverter. Okay, so because this is always off, so you will not get the high logic, never you will get the logic high. Okay, so either Vin is 0 or 1, you will not get logic high. Okay, so this will not act as an inverter. Now let us try to consider the other combinations as well. So the third combination could be, like, suppose somehow I have connected this to the output voltage. Okay, so can anyone tell me how this circuit will behave? So what you have to do, let me explain. You have to check what is the VGS, VDS and other potentials for the load transistor, and accordingly you can decide whether it is in active mode or it is in the cutoff mode or in saturation mode. Okay, so see here, this is the gate terminal, this is the source, and this is the drain. Okay, so if you see here, VGS is equal to V out minus VDD. Okay, and if we talk about the VDS, VDS is equal to, this is also V out minus VDD. So to check whether the device is in the saturation on or in the cutoff region, okay, you have to check whether the VDS is less than VGS minus VTS, or it is greater than VGS minus VTH. Okay, so because the VDS, so here if we see, we know that the condition for the linear region is VDS must be less than VGS minus VTH. This is the condition for the linear region, and the VDS greater than is equal to VGS minus VTH for saturation. So can anyone check which of these two conditions is satisfying by these two values? So we have these two because the VGS is equal to VDS. And if we see here, none of the condition is going to be satisfied, right? If none of the condition is going to be satisfied, what it means? This device will be in the off state. Okay, so if it is in the off state, because see, here we have the VGS is equal to VDS, and the conditions are different, like VDS is less than VGS minus VTH, and the other condition is VDS is greater than VGS minus VTH, something like that. But here, this component and this component is equal. So here, this is the additional one. Okay, so if both the condition is not satisfying, what it means? This will be in the cutoff region. So if this transistor will be in the cutoff region, so this will be in the cutoff. So if this is in the cutoff region, sir.
Sir, the first condition is true, right? Because VGS equal to VDS and VTH is negative.
VTH is negative. Yes. Good. Sorry. So here is this VGS is no, but the thing is, this is the case. Yeah, let me clear your doubt. So for the PMOS transistor, because this one is the PMOS transistor, so condition will be different. So here for the linear one, I need to consider this one. VDS must be greater than this one. And for this one, this must be the condition. So this is the condition for the PMOS transistor. PMOS transistor characteristics is opposite than the NMOS transistor. So because here we have the pull-up network is made of the PMOS transistor, so this will be the condition. So can we check which of the condition is going to satisfy?
Sir, second condition.
Second condition is going to be satisfied?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so VGS minus VTS, so this will be become positive. Yeah, so now this transistor will be in the saturation region. So if this is in the saturation region, then this device is in on state, and this will be the, here it will be the, so this now is it depends on what is the status. Okay, so what is the status of input? Okay, so can you check what is the output if Vin is equal to 0 and if Vin is equal to 1? Can you comment on this?
Sir, if Vin is 0, then Vout is VDD.
Okay, yeah, this is perfectly visible because this will be in the off state. Okay, so you will get like VDD.
Sir,
okay.
And if Vin is 1, then again, I think that 2 resistance.
Okay, so if Vin is equal to 1, then I need to check. Okay, so if Vin is equal to 1, this logic will be transferred to here. Okay, because this is in on state. So this, I'm assuming the Vout will become 0. Now check the conditions. Check the condition like here, Vout becomes 0. And if Vout becomes 0, then which of these two conditions are satisfying? And we need to check what is the status of the load transistor. Okay. If Vin is equal to 1, this ground will be transferred to this one here.
Voltage divider, whichever.
Okay, so it will act as a voltage divider, right? Okay, so this will be the same, just like a figure, a circuit number 1. Okay, so the what is the VOL and VOS, that completely depends on what is the sizing of the transistors. Okay, so yes, so here it will again, this circuit will act as an inverter, and this above transistor will be in the saturation region. Okay, and that is why this circuit is also known as saturation load, saturation PMOS load inverter circuit. Okay, so this is one of the reasons. So I am removing these parts because I need to have some more circuit on this block. Yeah, so this will this circuit will act as an inverter, but what is the output that depends on the sizing of these two transistors. Next possible combination could be something like this. Let us try to connect input and output with at the same node. Yes, so this is the simplest circuit which we have already studied. So this will simply act as a CMOS inverter. Yeah, this is nothing but this is a CMOS inverter, and definitely this will act as a inverter. Okay, so these are some of the combinations if we have the PMOS kind of load. But the question is, suppose I have so just now what kind of things we have studied? We studied like if I have replaced the load transistor with the NMOS transistor and the PMOS transistor, how this circuit will behave, whether it will act as a voltage divider circuit or it will act as a perfect inverter circuit. So this depends on what kind of connections we have made. Okay, but the thing is, we can also have some different kind of things, different kind of transistors like depletion mode transistors. So as of now, what we have considered all the load transistors are made of the enhancement one only. Okay, but if I'm considering, I have a load with the depletion kind of. So this is the symbol for the N MOSFET with the depletion. So depletion N MOSFET is represented by this kind of symbols. Okay, now let us try to check few of the combinations. Okay, before I just go for the explanation of this circuit, let me tell you how this circuit behaves. If I have the NMOS transistor, so the NMOS transistor characteristics is something like this. Okay, so this is something just like this. So here it is the pinch off voltage, which is the negative. And what happens initially, if you have to turn off the device, you need to make it in the off state. So initially this kind of devices are on state, and that is why we call them normally on transistor. Okay, so at zero voltage they are normally on, but if you have to turn off, you have to forcefully apply some negative voltage so that you can make it off. Okay, now the question is, yeah, so this is nothing but this is the VGS. So if the VGS is negative and is equal to VP, then it will be in off state, or it is more negative than this one, means if VGS is less than this VP, then this device will be in on state, off state, and otherwise it will be in the on state. Now let us try to check the some combinations.
Sir, this is for enhancement or depletion?
This is for depletion one. This characteristic is for depletion one. So I have already told you, this is for NMOS, which is the depletion one, and for the enhancement one, it looks like this one. So this is the characteristics for the enhancement kind of NMOS transistor, where this is the VTH and this is the VGS. So this is the difference between depletion MOSFET and the enhancement MOSFET. So this I have already told you. Okay, so the actual difference between these two kind of enhancement and the depletion, both are the characteristics for NMOS. Okay, if I am talking about the enhancement one, in enhancement one, the device is normally in off state, but if you have to turn on the device, you have to increase the VGS, which is greater than VTS or equal to VTS, so that the device will be in the on state. But in case of the depletion mode, initially at zero VGS, the transistor is in on state, but if we have to make it turn off, your VGS must be less than the pinch off voltage. Okay, so this is the pinch off voltage. So this is the characteristics of, so this is for depletion one and this is for the enhancement one. Now let us try to find some of the characteristics. First condition is, let us assume I have connected these two grounded. Okay, so can anyone tell me how this, what is the status of this enhancement NMOS transistor? Depletion NMOS transistor?
On.
It will be in on state. Okay, so let us try to check how it is in on state. So, initially, if it is grounded, so if it is grounded, what it means, you have connected the gate terminal to the ground state. So if you have connected gate terminal to the ground state, what it means, simply drain, this is the source. So VGS will be here. If you see, this is the gate terminal. So VGS is nothing but this is zero minus V out. Okay. So if the V out cannot be negative, right? So either it could be zero or V0. It could be zero or it could be some positive value. So let us consider two cases. If the V out is zero, in this case, what will happen? VGS will be zero. And if the VGS is equal to zero, this is the point where this transistor will be operated. Okay. So that this transistor will be in the on state. Similarly, the next possibility could be like the V out is VDD. Okay. So in that case, VGS is nothing but this is minus VDD. Minus VDD will be somewhere here. This is the point. Okay. So it depends on what is the status. But if initially I have connected something like this, so this will be in the on state. Okay. Now I need to check what is the input characteristics. And accordingly, you need to decide how this circuit will behave. You got the answer? You got the point what I'm saying? Let me explain it again. Suppose initially the V out is equal to zero. Okay. So if the V out is equal to zero, in that case, the VGS is nothing but it is equal to zero. And if it is equal to zero, this is the point which we are considering. Okay. And if we are considering this point, in that case, this transistor will be in the on state. Okay. So if Vin is equal to one, in this case, this is in on state, this ground will be transferred here. And if it is like this, this transistor will be in the on state. So both the transistor will act will be in on state, so it will act as a voltage divider circuit. Okay, now let us check the other case. Other case means like this is the zero, and if it is zero, this is the off, this is in the off state, and we are considering this device is in on state. So if this is in on state, this will give you the like this VDD will be transferred to the V out. Okay, so these two are the logic. What it means, if Vin is equal to zero, this VDD will be transferred to the V out. And if Vin is equal to one, in that case, it will act as a voltage divider because both the transistors are in on state.
Sir, can you explain the case Vin equal to zero, why the above transistor will be in on state? Because it will depend on V out, right?
Yeah, so initially, if I'm considering the initial state, the like capacitor is discharged. Okay. So if it is discharged, then this will be like VGS will be zero, and that's this transistor will be in on state. Okay, because this node is not going to be charged or discharged by this transistor. Okay, but the other thing, like if the previous case, like if this capacitor is initially charged to some value, then VGS will be this one. So the activation of this transistor depends on what is the status of this one. Okay, what is the status of this load capacitance or the whatever the circuits we have connected? Okay, so this is how it will behave. So initially,
sir,
yeah.
So once V out is reached to VDD, then transistor will be off, and then again that cycle will run up, right?
Which one? You are saying like V out is charged to VDD, okay? So yeah, so if it is charged, so it, see, the important thing is it cannot charge up to VDD, because see what happens in after certain case, like this is the zero, so this gate voltage is zero, okay? And if it is zero and initially this is also zero, for example, initially it was zero, let me make it proper, otherwise you will be, yeah, so initially this is, let us assume it is zero. So the VGS is equal to zero. VGS is equal to zero means this transistor is in on state. This one is in on state. And if this is in on state, what it means, this VDD will transfer to the V output one. Okay. Once this capacitor will start charging. Okay. So it is not like it will immediately transfer. It will keep on charging from zero value to VDD. And once this condition satisfied, okay, once this condition is satisfied, this transistor will becomes in on state. So it cannot charge your logic level to the VDD. Okay, it will never be the VDD. Because see, once the condition is 0, 0, like VG is equal to zero and VS is equal to zero, this transistor is in on state. And if it is in on state, the capacitor will start charging through this one. and this capacitor will be charged something like this, but it will get some condition of this pinch off point, and at this, after this particular point, it will not go beyond this one. Okay, it will not reach to the minus VDD or minus VGS. Okay, it will not reach to this particular point, or minus VGS is equal to minus VDD. So once the pinch off occurs, this transistor will be off, so it cannot charge your capacitor to the maximum VDD. Okay, so it can charge up to the pinch off point only, pinch off voltage only.
Okay, sir. एक बार वो चार्ज हो जाएगा उसके बाद वो कट जाएगा.
Yes. Once it is charged and it crosses to this point, then it will be turn off, and if it is turn off, it cannot further charge. So the maximum charge, maximum voltage that can be charged on this capacitor will be the pinch off, equivalent to the pinch off voltage of this depletion type NMOS transistor. Okay, you got the thing what I'm saying? Any doubt?
Yes, sir. No doubt.
Okay, fine. So this is how, what it means. It means that the maximum voltage which you can get is the equal to the pinch off voltage, and the minimum voltage is the logic zero. So the logic swing for this circuit will be between zero and the pinch off point, and the pinch off point is the very low voltage. Okay, so this will not act as an inverter. This is the very low value. Okay, so this will not act as an inverter circuit.
Sir, if we why will the lower one be zero? Like if Vin is one, then won't it behave like voltage
See,
divider?
If Vin is equal to zero, this point is clear.
Yes, sir.
Okay, now let us consider the Vin is equal to one. So if the Vin is equal to one. So let me consider the Vin is equal to 1. This transistor will be in the on state. Okay, if this transistor is on state, this ground will be connected to this one, and this will become the zero. Okay. So this will become to the zero. So VGS is equal to zero, and that will be, okay, I think I made one mistake here. If it is on.
Sir, then ऊपर वाला भी तो ऑन हो जाएगा ना
नहीं बट द थिंग इफ इट इज ऑन यदि ऑन हुआ सो इट विल स्टार्ट चार्जिंग दिस कैपेसिटर ओके सो इफ इट विल स्टार्ट चार्जिंग दिस कैपेसिटर एंड वंस दिस कैपेसिटर इज चार्ज टू वीपी अगेन दिस विल बिकम इन ऑफ स्टेट राइट सो इट विल बी जीरो ओनली राइट सो इट कैन स्विच बिटवीन वीपी एंड द जीरो ओनली लेट मी एक्सप्लेन इट अगेन प्रॉपरली यू गॉट द आंसर और आई नीड टू एक्सप्लेन इट अगेन
Sir, please explain it.
Okay, fine. So I think the input zero is final, right? You are able to understand it, how it is working. Okay, now let me explain input is equal to one. Okay, let me remove few things so that it will be easy to understand. Okay, now if input is equal to zero, input is equal to one, in this case, this transistor is in on state. And if, let me change the color, otherwise the red is giving too much red. This transistor will be in on state. Okay, so if input is equal to one, this transistor is on state, this ground will be transferred to this one. So this potential will become zero. And if this potential will become zero, VGS across this transistor becomes zero, and this is in on state. And if this is in on state, what will happen? It will act as a voltage divider circuit, means on resistance of this one and the on resistance of the below one, and it will be something like this. Now it depends on the transistor sizing, so the output voltage that depends on what is the size of this one. Okay, so if the size of this transistor is very high, so in that case it will move towards the VP, and if it is low, then it will move towards the VI. Yes. You corrected me in one point. So the behavior will be something like this one, and this maximum minimum value will always be equal to VP, but this value can be something like this, and that depends on the W by L of the let us assume this is the M2, so M2. Okay, so this is how it will be.
Sir, VP is the maximum voltage, right? The highest it can achieve.
VP is the, how VP is the maximum voltage?
We just saw if the Vin is zero, then the upper transistor can, the capacitor can only charge up to VP.
Yeah, so if it is, I made mistake. Yeah, so this will move here and this VP is something like this. Yeah, so this is how the, this VP is also decided by this particular thing. So this is the behavior, and the, because this swing is very less actually. If this is, this swing is very less, this will not act as an inverter.
Sir, and this up you have showed that it is all branching. So it's all should start from VP and niche branch hona chahiye na thoda.
Which one? Is all one?
Yes, sir. Means.
So this depends on the sizing of these two transistors, like NMOS and this one, M2 and M1. Okay, so that, if M,
means the high voltage is fixed at VP, but the lower voltage will be depend on sizing, right?
It will be something like this, but the swing is very less, right? So it will be VP in zero, but this will be shifted somewhere here. So because I made VP here, so the mistake was something like that. So the expression will be, so the final waveform will look like this one. And
sir, low voltage zero nahi hoga.
Kya chiz?
Low voltage zero nahi hoga, lower side.
Because see, once the condition is, if the M2 is in on state, this voltage becomes zero. And once this voltage becomes zero, then VGS of this above transistor will be zero. And once this becomes zero, this becomes in on state and suddenly it will start charging. So it will try to reach to the zero, but again, it will start charging because of this above depletion type of NMOS transistors. Okay, so the swing will be something like this.
Okay, sir. Wo zero se pehle bhi start ho jayega charge.
So once it is like, once the M2 is in on state, suddenly this the M1 transistor will start working, and if it is start working, this will start charging it up. Okay, so it will not reach to the zero, but it will suddenly it will try to charge, and the maximum voltage will be the VP only. So it will swing between VP and the zero. And because the VP is very low voltage, so this will circuit not will not act as a inverter circuit. Points are clear? Any
yes,
doubt?
Sir.
Okay. So this is the things which we need to consider. Okay. So I'm rough. I'm clearing some of the things. Fine. So the important characteristics, let me draw it here because it is really important. So the maximum is the VP and it will start doing like this. Here it will depend on this. So these kind of characteristics will look like. Next possible combination could be something like this. So let us try to check how this circuit will behave. Suppose I am connecting this circuit, the gate of this transistor to the VDD1. So can anyone comment how this circuit will behave? This is the gate, this is the source, this is the drain.
Sir, the up transistor will always be
so you need to check,
see up transistor will always be in turn on state.
In turn on state, how did you decide it,
sir? Because of VG is VDD.
See, the important thing is, let me tell you one more thing. This, the current characteristics of this depletion type MOSFET is not like an enhancement MOSFET. So if you see the drain current characteristics is given by IDSS 1 minus VGS upon VP. Okay, so this is the characteristics of drain current equations, where for the NMOS transistor, this VP is negative. And what is the value of VGS? Based on that, you can decide whether this is equal to, this is on or off. Okay, so this is how we decide the things. So can anyone come in? Square term is also there because it is 1 minus VGS upon VP whole square. This is just like a JFET characteristics.
Sir, that this depletion type will be off only if VGS is less than minus VP, right?
Yes.
Sir, but here the VGS will always remain greater than equal to zero because gate is at VDD.
Gate is at VDD, so VGS will always be equal to yes. So here if you see, VGS is either it is VDD, VGS is equal to VDD minus Vout. So the Vout can be two options, like either, so the VGS range will be from 0 volt to 0 to VDD. Vout is 0, 0 to VDD. So if VGS is equal to 0, so if the VGS, so this VP is, let me change the color. So this VP is a negative, okay? And to make this 0 or 1 minus, or so this VGS must be is equal to minus VP. And this condition will never come. Okay, so if this condition will never come, what it means, the VGS is always either it could be zero or it could be the VDD or in between. Okay, so this is always some component. And if there's some component, one minus that component will give some value always because it cannot be the one. Okay, and if it is like that, so one minus and minus sign from this VP, that will give you some positive. So one plus some positive value, and that will give you some ID. So this transistor is always in on state. Okay. So if this transistor is always in on state, then you need to check what is the input status. So if input is equal to zero, in that case, this is in off state. And if this is in off state, this VDD will be transferred to the V output. Because the VDD, this VGS can swing between the zero and VDD, and we have considered both the cases. Okay, in both the cases, this device will be on. So if this device will be in off, this VDD will be transferred to the V output. So for Vin is equal to zero, this V out VDD will be transferred to the V out. But if Vin is equal to one, in this case, this transistor is in on state. Okay, now it will act as a voltage divider from kind of structure. Any doubt what I said, or I need to repeat it again? Please go through it. I'm giving 1 minute time to think for both the cases. Yeah, first what you need to do, you need to first check what is the conditions of this one. So because the gate terminal of depletion one is connected to the VDD, and the VGS will be nothing but VG is VDD. And then VS is V out. So it will be like VDD minus V out. And the V out can have two possible conditions or in between anything. So the minimum condition could be like zero. And the maximum condition could be like VDD. Okay. If it is zero, VGS will be the VDD. And if it is VDD, then it will be zero. So it will always be positive. That will swing between zero and VDD. And if VGS is positive, so this value is positive, always positive. And this value is negative. So this part can never will become zero. And if this part can never will become zero, this ID can never be zero. And if ID can never will zero, like what it means, the transistor will be in the on state. Okay, so this transistor is in on state, like, so then it will check the both the input combinations. Like if Vin is equal to zero, then the lower transistor will be in off state, and then this VDD will be transferred to the Vout. Okay, and in other case, like if Vin is equal to one, then because both the transistors are in on state, then the voltage divider kind of circuit will work. Okay, so the output behavior will look like this one. So the maximum potential that can charge will be the VDD, and it will be behave like this, and this is how it will behave. So this depends on the sizing of this NMOS transistors. Okay, and based on that, it will look like this. Any doubt from here? Anyone?
सर वन क्वेश्चन
या प्लीज
सर ये जो कर्व होगा जो आपने ग्रीन में ड्रॉ किया है उसमें जो ऊपर वाला पार्ट होगा डब्ल्यू बाय एल हाई के लिए होगा ना
डब्ल्यू बाय एल
मोर डब्ल्यू एल
हाँ हाँ सो दैट 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 डिपेंड्स ऑन व्हिच डब्ल्यू बाय एल यू आर टारगेटिंग लाइक सी इफ द डब्ल्यू बाय एल ऑफ दिस वन इज वेरी स्ट्रॉन्ग ओके सो इफ डब्ल्यू बाय एल इज हाई फॉर दिस वन Okay, so if the W by L is high, what it means resistance will be lower, and if resistance will be lower, so voltage across this one will be less. So if the voltage across this one will be less, it will be shifted to the downward side. So yeah, so I'm talking about the pull down side one or the below transistor one.
Okay. Yes, so yes, I got that.
Yeah. So it's stronger. Yeah. So it's, let me write the M2. So this is the sizing of M2. So if M2 is stronger, then the waveform will shift towards to the downward side. Okay, got it?
Yes, I got it.
Fine. So this was the some. So this is always on. So these expressions are very important. Like you should know the current expression for both the things. I'm removing here because I will have one more circuit, but you should note. Yeah, in video it will be there, so you can go through it. Okay, so this was the other combinations. Now the third combination could be like if I have the connection which is something like this. Okay, can anyone comment how this will look like?
Sir, VGS is zero, so the up transistor is always on.
Okay, so it will act like the first case of yeah this circuit, right?
Yes sir, it will act like so means if Vin is zero, then
The VDD will be transferred,
and if Vin is one, then again voltage divider.
Yes, so this will how it will behave. Okay, so I don't think I need to explain in detail because it is clearly visible. Okay, next combination could be like if I have connected the both the input to the same terminal, then can anyone comment how it will behave? Yeah, this is really very interesting combination.
So जब जीरो होगा बीन जब जीरो होगा तो बी आउट वीडीडी पे चार्ज हो जाएगा.
If Vin is equal to zero, then
बी आउट विल शिफ्ट टू वीडीडी लाइक बी आउट वीडीडी हो जाएगा. जब वन होगा तो फिर
Sir, but V out can never be more than VP, right? Because once it crosses VP, then wo VG, then VGS will. If Vin is zero, and yes. If we assume that initially there is no charge, then the first the up one will be on, but then it will only charge up to VP, because after VP, then zero minus VP, it will become more negative than VP.
Perfect. So this is not like an inverter. The maximum swing will be between VP and the zero only. Okay.
Sir, like first case, I think.
And so if Vin is equal to zero, then the maximum charge could be like the VP, up to the VP, maximum voltage. And if it is one, in that case, this pull down transistor will be activated. And if this transistor is activated, this zero will directly be transferred to the Vout. So the output voltage will become zero. Okay, so the maximum swing will be between VP and the ground. And because this VP is very less, this will not behave as an inverter. Okay, you got the point, or I need to explain it more?
Sir, if VIN is 1, then 1 will transfer to Vout. Zero will transfer to Vout.
Yes. So if VIN is equal to 1, so this transistor is in on state and this is in on state. So this ground will be transferred to this one. So if ground will transfer to this one, means the output will become zero.
Sir, and then the up transistor will also be in on state.
But because if it is in on state and this is also in on state, because up transistor is always in on state. How it could be?
VIN is 1.
Mm-hmm.
Then Vout will be, the ground will be transferred to Vout.
Mm-hmm.
Then for the up transistor, VGS, up transistor will also become on because...
Okay, so this is 0 and this is the VG. One. Yeah, so this is VGG. Let us assume it is the VDD. Okay, so if it is VDD, so the VGS, if you talk about VGS here, VGS is equal to VDD, VD. It becomes the VDD. And if it is VDD, so this transistor will be in on state again. So if it is in on state, then it will act as a voltage divider circuit, right? You are saying like that. Is it? Can you confirm where
yes,
I'm getting?
I think it will. That is why.
Okay. So what will happen? Let me explain. Here, if the VIN is equal to 1, in that case, below transistor is always VIN on state. Okay. So this logic 0 will be transferred to this one. Okay. But what happens at the same time, VGS of this above transistor is also, it will become like VDD minus 0. Okay. And if VDD minus 0, what it means, the VGS is equal to VDD. And if VDS is equal to VDD, so this transistor will be in the on state. And if this transistor will be in on state, this will try to charge this voltage. But it can charge up to the VDD one, VP only. And once it will reach the VP, it will again discharge. So it will try to maintain the same logic VP. And if the the second transistor or this NMOS transistor, which is in the pull down side, is a stronger one, then it can pull down to the zero. Otherwise, it will again swing something like this. Okay. So if this one is more stronger, then it will try to maintain the VP only. So the maximum voltage that can be maintained to the VP. Okay.
When it is Vout is zero, then VGS is VDD for up transistor.
Yes.
And why it will try to charge up to VT? Because VDD tak ki charge hoga, tab bhi to on hi rahega.
Yeah, so VP, up to the VP it will charge, right? So it will charge up to VP. Once this voltage reaches, like this output voltage reaches to the pinch of voltage, then this combination will be like this VDD minus.
VDD minus VP, tab bhi toh positive hi rahega.
Okay.
Kyunki VP toh bahut small quantity hota hai VDD se.
Okay, so it will keep on charging. You're saying like it will keep, So it will keep on charging. And so let me clear few points. Let me
rough. Yes, sir. Because will never be more than VDD.
Mm-hmm. So let me point out it here. Yeah, let me make it properly. Yeah, so now the today's lecture is really very interactive. So I like this kind of lectures. So here, if you see, let us try to check both the cases. Okay, so let us consider first case. If VIN is equal to zero, if VIN is equal to zero, this is in off state. If this is in off state, the VGS, like this transistor is always in on state. So initially it is in on state. Then it will give you some output voltage. Okay, so it will be is equal to VP. Okay, so that is perfectly fine. Now let us talk about the second case. If the input is one, then this will be on, and if this is on, means the ground or the zero voltage will be transferred to here. What it means, I have connected VDD over here, and if the VDD is here, so the VGS is equal to VDD. So this will be in on state and it will start charging. Okay, once it reaches to the VP, means the VGS is nothing but this is the VDD minus VP. Okay, and this VDD minus VP is even greater than the logic zero, like it will not make this device off. Okay, so VDD minus VP will not make this device off, so still it will keep on charging. And yes, yeah, so in that case it will what it will do, it will simply
a voltage divider only,
so keep on charging and it will act as a voltage divider circuit. Yes, so the upper voltage depends on the lower voltage is always VP. Okay, and the upper so it will swing, like the upper voltage will depends on what is the sizing. Okay, and the lower voltage it could be zero.
Sir, it will be like first case only. The higher voltage can never go above VP, and lower voltage will depend on the sizing of the two
transistors. Sizing of the transistors. Yes. Yes. So so the important thing is we do not.
Sir, can you repeat last part? Higher voltage.
Which one? Higher voltage and lower voltage. Yeah. So let me check. So in which case you are talking? Input one or input zero?
Like अभी आपने लास्ट में किसके बारे में बात किया, वन या जीरो के बारे में?
See, let me explain it again. What happens if the input is equal to one? Okay, if the input is equal to one, this transistor is on, and if this transistor is in on state, so this will put here, like the output will become zero, and if this output will become zero, the pull-up network is all it will also be in on state, and if it is in on state, this the V out or this capacitor will start charging through this one, and still if it reaches to the VP, again there is a difference, like VDD minus VP, and this will keep on charging, and that charge, like and that depends on like, so this is on, this transistor is also on, so up to what voltage it will charge, that completely depends on which transistor is more stronger. So if this transistor is more stronger, it will force the output voltage to keep at the lower side only, and if it is the weak one, then the upper one will be the responsible to charge up to the VDD minus VP. Okay, so the charging and the discharging, that will depends like this voltage. Yeah, so here the behavior will be something like this. It will be something like this, and the upper voltage, that depends on the sizing of the transistor. Okay, so up to what voltage it can charge, that depends on what is the strength of these transistors. So if the pull down transistor is stronger, in that case it will be it will maintain up to the VP, but if the pull up network is stronger, it will pull up to the more voltages, and it will be up to VDD minus VP. It will charge up to the certain voltage levels. You got the point, or I need to clear it again?
Sir, how it can go above VP? That I did not understand. The higher voltage.
Higher voltage. Okay. So what happens? Lower voltage is fine, right? Higher voltage. What will happen? Once this, if the strength of this above transistor is more, if the strength of this above transistor is more, what it means? The on resistance of above transistor is smaller, and if on resistance is smaller, what it means, this VDD will keep on charging this load capacitance even higher than the VP. Okay, because even though if it is higher than VP, this the VGS will be VDD minus VP plus some value. Okay, and it will do the same until it will reach to the some equal to the pinch off kind of the voltage difference between this gate to source will be equal to the VP. So this will keep on charging something like that. You got the point or not? Point is clear or not?
Oh, sir, means Vin is 1, so then VG is VDD for the depletion.
Yes, so see, because the so Vin is 1, VG is VDD, and if it is VDD, then that depends on what is the VGS. Okay, so VGS means what will happen? This VGS will always be positive. And if this is always positive, so this transistor will always be in on state. And if that this transistor is always being on state, now this what is the output logic? That depends on how much strong this depletion type MOSFET is. If the depletion type of MOSFET is more stronger, then it can charge up to the VDD. So this capacitor can charge up to the VDD because of the stronger depletion MOSFET. Okay, and how much the what is the maximum voltage? That completely depends on what is the strength of this depletion one. Similarly, if the strength of these NMOS transistor is more stronger, then it will not move above this one. It will keep on it will keep up to certain lower values only. So the strength of so W by L of depletion one. I don't need to write D, otherwise it will act as a driver. So I'm talking about the load. What happens? Okay. So W by L of load transistor. So if the W by L of the load transistor is keep on increasing, then this high voltage can be more. It can reach up to the VDD. Yes.
Thank you, sir. The next class is in queue.
So this is how this circuit will work. Okay. So I'm closing session here only. Yes, of course, this circuit will act as a inverter. And what is the maximum and the minimum value that depends on the strength of these two transistors. So yeah, please go through it. In case of any doubt, we will
discuss. Can we take this up next class then?
Yeah. No problem. Thank you so much. I'm closing the session now.